Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy Nacuban. In this video, I want to explore the new on-object editing a little bit and show you some things that you may not know. I've been thinking about this. I didn't want to do just a straight feature video on this, and so I played around with it, and I found those three things that I think you may be interested in. Maybe you know, maybe you don't, but you know we like to do it here on Guy Nacuban. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. All right. Of note, as of the recording of this video, this is a preview feature, so you need to turn that on if you haven't done so already. And right away, we see some things that are different. My format pane's gone, the visualizations were moved up here. And so a couple of things to point out here. I'm just gonna use this line chart as an example. If I select it, you know, I get these buttons where I can adjust the visual, I can get to the formatting options, all that's fine. That's part of the main feature of on-object editing. But I was going around and I'm like, I heard you could change this title in the visual. Let's see how we can do that. So I'm going to double click on the visual and it turns into this blue. I don't know if you can see this blue outline color. I don't know what the official name of this is, but I'm going to call this the blue Guy Nacuban editing line. And then if I select on the title, now I can change the name of this. So I don't know if you noticed this as I was typing, it already went to the title area and it changed this inline as I was typing. That's amazing. The other thing, let me go back out here so we get rid of the Guy Nacuban blue editing line. If I just right click on the visual, we'll see the normal context menu that we have. But if I double click again and I'm inside that blue Guy Nacuban editing line and I right click, now I get a context menu that's relevant to the visual. And so if this is a bar chart, then you can edit the individual lines. And so let's just right click here on the actual line. I can add markers, I can add series labels. If I right click on the axis, I can sort the axis, I can format the axis. So we can actually get context relevant items to edit as I'm searching. So no more fumbling around with the format pane. You can still do that. It's still an option. But just know that this is an area that you can just do directly in the visual. Not all of the visuals yet have been updated with this. I did notice in the April 2023 Power BI desktop that the card visual now has some capabilities with on-object editing. So I expect this to roll out for other visuals as we go forward. The other thing I want to point out here is we've got these different panes that we can switch between. So right now I'm on the format pane, right here I'm on the data pane. And you're like, look, maybe I get a big monitor. Maybe I want to see these things side by side. I don't want to keep having to flip back and forth. And so one thing I can say is, okay, the format pane, I want to say we can collapse, we can close it. But if I right click on the data pane, because it's not the currently opened one, I can say open in a new pane. And now I can have these side by side. What? And so you can do this with different items. Let's try another one. So let me go to view. We'll go to performance analyzer, right? It's another pane. So let's go to data. We'll say open in a new pane, bam. And I can say format, open in a new pane. And I can just keep going and going. So if that was your jam and you want it to be more like what it was before, you can go through and, you know, open those in a new pane and you can have them side by side if you need to. It's amazing. There's these little nuggets all over the place with on-object editing. I love it. Let me know in the comments if you knew about these or if you know of other little nuggets that you want to share with everyone else. Let's keep the conversation going. And if you like visualization type videos, check out this video I did on the slicer panel. It's amazing and you will thank me for it later. All right. Thanks for watching. Keep being awesome and we'll see you in the next video.